the cold and flu season, we always hear it's important to wash your hands, but there's a proper way to do it. News 8 on Your Side medical reporter Susan Shapiro got some tips when she visited a class at YTI Career Institute in York.
Let's try it again.
These students are studying to be medical assistants. They could end up working in your doctor's office or a clinic.
So go ahead and put them on.
Among the things they learn, gloving and hand washing to prevent the spread of germs. It's a lesson we all could take, especially during flu season.
I don't think we always realize how much we come in contact with people throughout the day. And then one of the primary places we touch is our face, and everything that we've touched is on our hands.
Cindy Nichols gets the water running. Instructor Moultrie says it doesn't matter if it's hot or cold.
Once you get your hands wet, you're going to go ahead and get some soap. All right. And you want to make sure that you get it on both sides of your hand, the palm side as well as the front, that you pay special attention to the area under your nails. So once you feel like you've gotten it worked up into a nice soapy lather, that's key. We're trying to go for at least 20 seconds.
Moultrie says avoid touching the sink where the dirty water runs. And then dry your hands with a clean paper towel or even air dry them.
It's not just, you know, sticking your hand under water for 5 seconds. You actually have to, like, you take your time, do it, scrub your hands, make sure you get under your nails, like, very detailed.
If you're not sure if you're washing your hands for 20 seconds, the CDC has a tip. Hum the happy birthday song to yourself twice.
Moultrie also demonstrates the use of hand sanitizer, but says nothing can replace good old-fashioned soap and water. Susan Shapiro on Your Side, News 8.
Instructor Moultrie says you should not be afraid to ask your doctor or any healthcare worker to wash their hands before an examination.
Well, one of the biggest